Hi, second graders. We're going to look at some more sentences that have several mistakes in them. Up at the top of the screen, you're going to see all of the different things that we have to look for as we are correcting these sentences. So first thing, as we read through, we're going to draw a box around the proper nouns. Remember, proper nouns name a specific person, place, thing. We're going to circle the common nouns. We're going to fix any capital letters on proper nouns. We've learned that proper nouns have to have capital letters. Last time we looked at proper nouns that had titles like Mr., Mrs., or Ms., or Miss. And so we want to make sure that as we see those in our sentences that we fix any capital letter or punctuation mistakes on those titles. We know that sentences have to have a capital letter at the beginning, so we want to make sure we do that. We have to add punctuation at the end of our sentence. And then the last two, we're going to be drawing some lines under the verbs. We're going to draw a squiggle line, and under the possessive nouns, the nouns that show ownership, we're going to put a straight line. So let's look at our first sentence. Mr. Smith counted foxes and wolves with three men last October. So let's first look through and see if we can find any proper nouns. And we're going to put a box around those proper nouns. So look at that sentence. Mr. Smith counted foxes and wolves with three men last October. Do you see any proper nouns, nouns that name a specific person, place, or thing? There are actually two in this sentence. The first one is Mr. Smith. That is naming a specific person. So let's go ahead and put a box around Mr. Smith. Do you see another proper noun in this sentence? It's actually the last word of the sentence, and it is the proper noun that names the specific month of October. So let's go ahead and put a box around that proper noun. All right, so step number one, put a box around or draw a box around the proper nouns is finished. Go ahead and go to number two, circle the common nouns. Remember, common nouns name a person, place, or thing. They just don't give a specific name to them. So Mr. Smith counted foxes and wolves with three men last October. Do you see any words that name a person, place, thing? I'm also going to give you a hint that remember nouns, sometimes we say animals as well, person, place, thing, or animal. There are actually three common nouns in this sentence. The first one is foxes. Foxes name animals, so we're going to go ahead and circle foxes. Wolves are also, or is also a word that names a common noun. Circle that one. And the last one is men. Men names a common noun of a person or people. All of these three examples, foxes, wolves, and men, are all examples of plural nouns, more than one. With foxes and wolves, we know we see that ES at the end. Men, we know we have to change the word man. It's an irregular plural. We have to change the middle vowel to an E. So we've gone ahead and circled the common nouns. Let's go back to our proper nouns and fix any of the capital letters. We know that proper nouns have to have capital letters. So Mr. would have a capital M. Smith would have a capital S. Our other proper noun was October, so let's go ahead and change that O to a capital O. And we want to make sure that if any of our proper nouns have a title, Mr., Mrs., Ms., we want to fix the capital letters. And it also says punctuation. What is that punctuation that goes on the abbreviated titles? Do you remember that? You have to put a period after the abbreviations for Mr., Mrs., and Ms. Not Miss, though. If we have Miss in our sentence, that's a complete word. So October doesn't have any titles, that's just the word October, but Mr. Smith does, right? We have Mr. in there is an abbreviation of the longer word Mr. And so after that R, we actually have to put that period so that we remember that that is an abbreviation. Right, let's go on. Add a capital letter at the beginning of the sentence. Well, it actually worked out that Mr. Smith, that proper noun, was at the beginning of our sentence, so we actually already did change that to a capital letter. If that hadn't have been a proper noun, we would have had to make sure that that had a capital letter. Add punctuation at the end of the sentence. Mr. Smith counted foxes and wolves with 3 men last October. Is that sentence telling us something? Telling us something with some emotion behind it, or is it asking a question? That will make a difference, right, as to what punctuation we put at the end. Well, this sentence is just telling us, right, about Mr. Smith and what he did. That's a telling sentence, and with a telling sentence, we add a period. Finally, we're going to go back and we're going to look for the verb. So what's the action in this sentence? What is something that Mr. Fox did? Mr. Smith counted. Mr. Smith counted. So counted is our verb. So I'm going to draw a squiggly line under our verb. And there were no possessive nouns. Nothing in this had that apostrophe S. Nothing was showing ownership of something else. So Mr. Smith counted foxes and wolves with 3 men last October. Let's try the next sentence and see if that works too. Okay, let's go back. So we're going to draw a square around the proper nouns. Here's our sentence. Mrs. Jones, Jeff's mom, drove him and some children from his class to the park on Main Street on Friday. I have a feeling there are going to be several proper nouns in this sentence because I hear a lot of words that are naming a specific person, place, or thing. Let's start right at the beginning. Our first set of words here, Mrs. Jones, is naming a specific person. So, of course, that is a proper noun. We're going to draw a box around that. Look at the very next word, Jeff's. Jeff is naming a specific person again. So we're going to put a box around that. Mom isn't really naming a specific person, so we're not going to keep with that. Some children from his class to the park on Main Street. Main Street is naming a specific street, right? We would know right where to go if somebody said Main Street. So Main Street is a proper noun. So let's go ahead and put a box around that. And Friday is actually naming a specific day of the week, which is a specific thing. So that is also a proper noun. So let's go ahead and put a box around that. So 4 proper nouns in that sentence. All right, we're going to go back and we're going to circle the common nouns. So Mrs. Jones, Jeff's mom. Mom is naming a common person, right? Not a specific person, but just a general person. Mrs. Jones, Jeff's mom, drove him and some children, right? Children is a general word naming some people. So it is a common noun. From his class, class is naming a thing. To the park. Park is naming a place on Main Street on Friday. So we ended up with also 4 common nouns. How many of those nouns are singular? Just one. Mom is singular, just one mom. Class is singular, just one class. Park is singular, just one park. Children, though, is one of those irregular plurals, right? Because we had to change the word child to children. We couldn't just add an S. All right, let's go back to our proper nouns and we're going to fix those proper nouns to make sure that they have capital letters, right? Proper nouns always have to have capital letters. So Mrs. Jones, both the M and the J need to be capital. So let's go ahead and make that M capital and that J capital. Jeff needs a capital J. Main Street was another proper noun. The M and the S on Main Street need capital. and Friday, that specific day of the week. So let's put an F, capital F there. Okay. We're going to go back and look at any of the abbreviations on the titles of those proper nouns. Remember, we have to have a capital letter and we have to have that punctuation, right? The period after those abbreviations. Well, the only title that I see in this is on that first proper noun, Mrs. Jones. Mrs. is an abbreviation for a longer word. We need punctuation. And since it's already part of that proper noun, we already do have a capital letter on there. But we need to make sure that it has a period. We have to have a capital letter at the beginning of the sentence. Again, we have a proper noun beginning our sentence, so we already do have a capital letter. Let's add punctuation at the end of the sentence. Mrs. Jones, Jeff's mom, drove him and some children from his class to the park on Main Street on Friday. Is it telling us something? Telling us something with some emotion, or is it asking a question? This is just telling us about Mrs. Jones, right? We don't really have any emotion behind it, so we're going to go ahead and add a period, not an exclamation mark. Let's go back and look for the verb. We're going to put a squiggle line. Remember, a verb is something that can be done. So what is something that Mrs. Jones did? Mrs. Jones drove. Drove is the past tense of drive. We can't say drived. We have to change that. It's an irregular past tense. Drove is our verb. And finally, did we have any possessive nouns? A noun that's showing ownership. I'm going to give you a hint that when we have a possessive noun, we have an apostrophe S. Right. Jeff's is a possessive noun. We're going to put a straight line. Whose mom is it? Who does the mom belong to? It belongs to Jeff. So it's showing that possession. So all of these editing marks that we just did are what you're going to be doing on your next assignment.